Hi guys, it's MTG here, and today I'm going to be going over some tips and tricks for your Google Pixel 2 and Google Pixel 2 XL. And with those, I'll be showing you some cool new features that Android Oreo brings to the table. Right now, very few devices are running Android Oreo, but as this software update comes, you can expect to see a lot of these cool new features on a wider range of devices. I hope this video helps you out, and let's get right into it. The Pixel 2 has a hidden dark theme that isn't anywhere in the settings. It makes the pull-down notification shade black as opposed to its usual white. To activate this feature, simply change your background to something dark. Once you do this, your notification shade will automatically change and become black. If you hate it when people use your phone when you're trying to just show them one thing, the Pixel 2s have this feature where you'll be able to pin an app to the screen. To turn this on, go into Settings, then scroll to Security and Location. From here, scroll to the bottom and toggle on Screen Pinning. Now when you're in an app that you want to pin, click the menu icon on the bottom and then click the pin icon. Once the screen is pinned, the user will not be able to leave the app. To get out of this mode, hold down the menu and back buttons at the same time. The phone will then require you to enter your pin or fingerprint once again. Especially with the Pixel 2 XL, the notification shade could be tricky to pull down. But you can help this problem by turning on the fingerprint sensor gesture. To turn this on, go into Settings, System, Languages, Input and Gestures, and then click Advanced. From here, you'll be able to turn on Swipe Fingerprint for notifications. Now when you swipe down once, you'll see any notifications as well as your first 6 quick toggles. And if you swipe down again, all of your quick toggles will be presented. The Ambient Display is the screen that shows the time and any notifications you may have on your phone. You'll be able to change various settings of this Ambient Display by going into Settings, Display, Advanced, then Ambient Display. From here, you'll be able to toggle on and off whether or not you want the Ambient Display to always be on. If you toggle this off, you'll be able to turn on and off whether or not you want the Ambient Display to be activated when you lift the phone. Whether the Ambient Display is on or not, you'll also be able to double tap to activate the screen. The next few tips involve the camera. To quickly launch the camera, you can double tap the power button. Then, once the camera is open, you can switch between camera modes by twisting the phone twice. Both of these features, if not on for you already, can be turned on by going into Settings, System, Languages, Input, and Gestures, then Advanced. These features are called Jump to Camera and Flip Camera, respectively. The camera has two other cool features on by default that I want to talk about. The first is double tapping to 2x zoom. There is no telephoto lens, but this feature will instantly 2x digitally zoom. The next feature locks the focus and exposure. When you tap the screen to focus on something, you can click the lock icon that appears on the right. And now your focus and exposure will both be locked. With Android Oreo, Google finally implemented a display toggle that will filter out blue light to help with sleep. In Oreo, this is called Nightlight. You will be able to turn this on by going into your quick toggles and clicking Nightlight. You'll be able to access more settings by holding down on the toggle. From here, you will be able to schedule a custom time for it to activate, or have your phone turn it on when the sun sets. When it's on, you'll be able to set the intensity of the amber tint as well. The Do Not Disturb function got some added functionality. You can turn it on and off from by going into quick toggles as usual. But also from the quick toggles, you can click the menu underneath and you'll be able to choose whether you want your phone to be completely silent, let alarms make sounds, or alarms and other exceptions that you can set in the Priority Only button. If you click the More Settings button, you'll be able to choose what the priority mode allows, block visual disturbances such as notifications from popping up on the screen, and you'll be able to make custom rules based on the time of week or the things you're doing. A cool new feature with Android Oreo is your ability to perform certain application actions directly from the app icons themselves. What I mean by this is that you'll be able to hold down the messaging icon and create a new conversation, hold down the phone icon and make a new contact, and a lot more quick actions on just about every app that comes pre-installed by Google, and will eventually spread to more apps as updates take the feature into account. Android has refined their implementations of screen splitting on Oreo. Now to activate screen splitting, simply go into your recent apps and drag the app to the top. Then choose the app you'd like to put on the bottom screen. You'll be able to easily resize the apps And to exit screen splitting mode, just hold down the multitasking button. With the Pixel 2s, you'll be able to have it automatically listen for songs playing around you. Google assures this feature is local on the device, meaning that it does not require an internet connection to operate. To turn this on, go into Settings, Sound, Advanced, and toggle on Now Playing. The last little hidden feature involves watching videos in the YouTube app. You can fill up the whole screen by simply pinching to zoom, and you can make the video its normal aspect ratio by just pinching back in. Hopefully you found some of those tips and tricks useful. I'm getting my iPhone 10 in later this week, so stay tuned for that. And if you liked that video, please give this video a thumbs up. I'm working on a ton of new content right now, so please click the logo down below to subscribe, and make sure to have the notification bell clicked to stay up to date on my latest videos. Check the description for links to my social media accounts, and as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.